What's up, guys? Kevin Cage here. Be sure to stick around. I just recorded this entire video and it did not record, so I'm going to do it again. One take, uncut, pay close attention. So, per the screenshot that I took last year, I'm sure many of you remember it. Feel free to take a screen grab. This is referring to when Visa and MasterCard were going back and forth trying to bid for a Ripple partner, Earthport, one of the biggest behemoths there is. We know, as we can see here, the announcement of Visa of this acquisition for a $320 million valued UK-based Earthport to unleash the power of Visa and take it beyond the card. And I know we've seen that phrasing before, and work with Ripple, the company, in creating an alternative to Swift payments. We also have this IPO in Dubai. We also have MasterCard right here. We know the connections. We've done a lot of deep dives. I also saw King Solomon's video that he put out the other day talking about some Ripple drop music. If you guys know the Ripple videos, well, funny enough, Visa was actually another player that put out a commercial and they used Ripple's music in the background. So whether that's a coincidence or a hint, you guys take that with a grain of salt and do your own research. Just wanted to share that. And we know that even the old videos years ago of Chris Larson, executive chairman of Ripple, well, I mean, he's name dropped Earthport in tandem with Swift and Visa numerous times on many occasions. Okay, so feel free to screenshot this. Now, let's keep speeding through this. National Bank of Ukraine, this is from 2019, talking about the central bank digital currency pilot with their e-hryvnia. Now, what's interesting is we actually have literally Stellar mentioned in this document numerous times. You guys can come find it right here if you want. You can go National Bank of Ukraine, integrate Stellar Lumen's protocol for CBDC pilot. I'm curious if they're much further than they were last year. You can just click the report right here if you want to see it for yourselves. Control find, kind of see the Stellar and, the blockchain are named, several times here if you want to read more about it. What's important to note, though, is I did not find the Lumen or XLM in this search. So take that with a grain of salt because we want demand for the actual native asset. Nonetheless, we know Jed McCaleb of, Stellar. He was one of the first architects for the XRP Ledger. He has deep family ties with the Federal Reserve. So this is just one of my projects. I think brother and sister XRP, XLM, gold, silver, however you guys want to see it. I do a lot of research with this and maybe I'll start talking a little bit more about XLM, but I want to see true demand for the token. And compared to many other assets, I mean, besides actually at scale, I think that XRP has some of the most sound fundamentals, but I own both and I love both. All right. Next, so the NYDIG.com, you guys can come here. As we know, they're an investment firm providing asset management, custody, execution services for some assets, including Ethereum, XRP, Bitcoin, the big typical legacy coins that we know. Remember last year, I think it was maybe like the last week of September, we had Chris Larson send a huge amount of XRP. It was probably millions or billions. He was actually sending it as the community freaks out and says Ripple's dumping on us. He said he was actually sending an XRP wallet to this group, the NYDIG. So we're familiar with this group, and let's keep in mind with them. Remember, what is it, the New York Department of Financial Services. We know the board members on Ripple. We know even people like Ben Lawsky. It is not coincidental. So watch New York City. They're a fintech, or not a fintech, but the financial capital of the world. Now I want to put things together with a really cool thread that many of you have not seen. So this is actually shared by Martin CP Volk. Definite follow on Twitter, guys. Stick around. I want you to hear about this because many people have not actually specifically dove into this to this degree. So this is the official New York State Department of Financial Services, the NYDFS. And that's what I was referencing like, 2 seconds ago with, Ben Lawsky and all these, Ripple board members and a lot of people there. So right here, looked into PayPal's access to cryptocurrency and a lot of XRP community members were, giving out about them not including XRP. Well, which is it? So he's going to dive in right here and I want to hear your thoughts down below. So PayPal made this announcement yesterday talking about account holders being able to buy, sell, hold cryptocurrencies with PayPal wallets. They cannot, take the Bitcoin out of there. They can only keep it and move it between PayPal wallets. So essentially you don't really own the private keys. There's a lot of disputing this. What's the point of cryptocurrency if the, networks aren't going to be open overall? And they have plans to expand into Venmo and some countries in the first half of 2021. Now, this is the Reuters article that I just touched on briefly yesterday, and there's two quotes that stuck out to him, and I think, this is a really good eye. Cryptocurrency license from the New York State Department of Financial Services, and right here, PayPal is teaming up with cryptocurrency firm Paxos Trust Company to offer the service. So, who is Paxos? Let's take a look. Right here, the link, Paxos.com, New York City, based out of their global presence. We get the gist, Singapore and London. Interesting. So in a lot of, you know, friendly jurisdictions besides New York City, but this is the capital. It, you know, is mostly the strictest. If you have clarity there, you're pretty much good for the globe. And that is, you know, pretty much well known in the world of finance because New York is very, very strict. And, you know, on the macro, the United States is, you know, very, very strict. So right here, let's check out the Department of Financial Services in New York. XRP is approved for custody right here. We can see right here, this is coins approved for custody, but coins approved for listing, it is not. Interesting. So we can click right here just so you can see it for yourselves. Ripple XRP on the left-hand side is approved for custody, but not for listing. Well, let's just break it down and go over the definitions of these two. Custody refers to the holding of assets on behalf of a client, okay? In listing, when an exchange offers trading pairs for a particular asset, this action is known as listing the asset. Now, here's a quote from CoinDesk article. PayPal service does not allow Bitcoin or other crypto to be withdrawn or deposited. Once you buy the coins, they stay in your account or, you know, your actual crypto wallet on PayPal until you sell. You're trapped there. This is, again, just another payment silo. As PayPal will not allow you to deposit or withdraw crypto, this takes the custody-only wallet option out of the picture. And as you have to buy crypto, it needs to be listed. Agreed. As the New York State Department of Financial Services does not allow XRP to be listed, only custodied as we saw, am I correct in thinking that PayPal could not offer XRP even if they wanted to? Now Galgatron chimes in. They could have offered XRP outside of New York. Lots of crypto companies treat New York differently. As we know, if you've been in even the cryptocurrency space or you've worked in finance for quite some time, in terms of regulations, New York is one of the most strict states in the world. All right, just wanted to share that. Thank you, Martin, for sharing. And I'm looking forward to kind of seeing some clarity and if there's any additional commentary from the people up top. All right. Next, really good find here. I'm just going to speed through this. Ripple investment partner, we know MoneyGram, is extending into Hong Kong throughout China with their new partner, Lulu Money. Now, we've seen Lulu before. Where at? Well, Lulu Money's parent company is Lulu Exchange, and they're headquartered right in Dubai. And we also know throughout the Middle East, Ripple is rather popular. We can even talk through, you know, the UAE, parts of Saudi Arabia, etc. So actually, Lulu Exchange, where we've gone over numerous times, is also a Ripple partner, and they are featured in Ripple's Cloud One Pager. I'm sure you guys remember that. So awesome find again by Wrath of Kahneman. And right here, just an additional quote here on Business Wire. The remittance industry plays a significant role in connecting communities and families. And by offering our network as a payout center of MoneyGram, we aim to make the process of money transfer more accessible, cheaper, and convenient for millions of Hong Kong residents. Awesome. So specifically tapping on and focusing on remittance. There's a huge initiative for financial inclusion, unbanked, underbanked. I think you guys get it. And to finish things off with a bang, shared by Panos Mac, definite follow. This is the BCG Boston Consulting Group Global Payments 2020 report, name dropping not only Ripple, but Earthport, which we covered in the beginning of this video, if you guys took a screenshot. Now, before going into this briefly, what have we been seeing across the board? Well, besides all these countries, I mean, even just pushes for regulation, we saw that recent article, all this growing crypto usage, even in sub-Saharan Africa, it's forcing regulators to reconsider the industry as a whole. Well, what are we seeing in the US? Personally, I know it has been slow and, you know, revolutionizing the entire world of finance does not happen overnight, and it hasn't. It's been going on for, you know, close to a decade at this point since the last financial crisis. But we're seeing US regulators saying banks could become blockchain nodes. We're seeing Brian Brooks saying that blockchain will disrupt banks. He's name dropped Chris Larson, you know, huge cost reductions for international payments, saying Ripple as well. And we see that regulators are finally seeing that banks are becoming directly connected to blockchains and DLT networks and using them as payment networks. This is what is happening in front of our eyes. We have Kraken that Ripple invested into, one of the first that has a U.S. banking charter license, or, you know, a U.S. License. It's happening right in front of our eyes, guys. Ignore the current price you see. When in doubt, zoom out. There are bigger things at play here. Not even trying to be hypey, but it will be happening, and it is going to be happening sooner than later. All right, so right here, infrastructure providers such as Ripple and Earthport often outperform banks in the overall customer experience. Because, you know, obviously banks are heavy, they're slow. These little fintechs, these smaller groups, that, you know, with this technology and the private company and funding, they can move a lot faster. To stay competitive, banks will need to change their approach altogether. If you guys want to read this, I guess it's pretty easy to see. You know, talking about Swift GPI, it is not necessarily an improvement. It helps to, you know, facilitate these payments, remittance, and reconciliation. But overall, guys, we want XRP to be one of the invisible protocols on the settlement layer of this whole payment stack. Okay? And let me see if there's anything else I want to go over. So right here, and we'll finish up. So structural changes are also needed. Banks should align their correspondent banking network, which is something that anyone that is into XRP, please study this extensively. Do not, I mean, if we have a lot of guys that are from other projects, and I love a variety of altcoins. I love Ethereum. Do not get me wrong. But if they do not understand this, what specifically XRP is trying to enable or disrupt or maybe replace altogether, they, you know, there's really no room for commentary on XRP. You can stick to DeFi. All right. So along the core trade and payments corridors. So notice banks need to align their correspondent banking network along core trade and payments corridors to ensure that they can provide customers with support in the regions where they trade. Offering competitive pricing is another must. Highly recommend kind of going through this. It's a lot of the things we already know, but we see all of these groups going through this, talking about SMEs, talking about the region. This is a global revolution occurring right in front of our eyes, and these opportunities come once in a lifetime. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.